If I never appeared tired before, I'm gonna be tired now, let me tell you what. And why? Because I've been at this for... this is... sixth time? The last time I just did it. Oh, because what the problem was... Last time I just had the microphone was off. I was recording. I have it hooked up from here straight into the mixer. And I'm using one of the Joyo pedals. So, you know, it's made for that. So that's fine and everything like that. But I had ticked off the microphone. So I'm over here, I'm yapping away, and I never bothered to check to see if the microphone was recording. For 20 minutes. I can't even tell if this is... I honestly can't even tell if this is coming out decent or not. Or not. I wish I could, but I can't. So I don't know what to tell you. Anyway. What's up? If anyone's been following the YouTubes, the Facebook posts. And I noticed a lot of YouTubers or the guys on YouTubes, you don't know. I'm Dan Lopez 2012 on everything. On everything. If you're following... if you're following me here... And you want to keep in touch, you know, up beyond here... I'm Dan Lopez 2012 on everything. On Twitter, on Facebook, on Instagram, which I can't get into all of a sudden except for on the... Except for on the PC. I don't have a normal password. I don't know what my freaking password is. I don't know what the stupid... And so now I can't... My phone won't freaking turn on. So I don't know what the hell the story is with that. But... Like, I had a Tumblr thing. That was Dan Lopez 2012. Like, everything was... Like, if you go... I think Instagram on Instagram. Insta pages. What was that other one? LinkedIn. LinkedIn was the only... I think even LinkedIn you could find me as Dan Lopez 2012, but I could be wrong. I could be wrong. I'm not on Snapchat. What was the other one? There was Instapages and... There was another one. I can't remember what the hell it was. If you were following me on those, you would have seen the recent updates that I had. This is the baby that's been sitting on the wall all by its lonesome, begging for me to play it, and begging and begging and begging and begging and begging. And I hadn't had the desire because it was too big. It was too big for me. And when I had bought it, I had originally... And I've said this so many times. When I had bought it, I had originally bought it because I saw an ES-125. That's what I saw when I bought it. The tag said Palomino. It said Dean Palomino. But I saw an ES-125. And I had told myself, well, at some point in time, if I ever have the balls, I'm going to turn this into a 125. If I can't turn it into a 125, I'm going to have the body blank to make one. So I don't know what or why. I don't know what possessed me to take it upon myself to go ahead and do it, because midnight was in line, and that was the one that was going to get it, because that needed it badly. I mean, it needs something, because it was, the neck is fine, but for some reason, no matter what pickups you put in there, no matter what you did to it, it just didn't, you know what I mean? So I don't know what the hell. So basically, I'm gonna have to do to that what I did to this, and this thing, I took a chunk, I took about an inch and a half off, you know, and then I took the back off, and after I took the back off, I recapped it. And so after I recapped it, before I recapped it, I did a few things. I rewired the pickups, because the ES-125 has two P90s, and this one had three. So in order to get it to play like an ES-125, I had to wire it up so that these two played together. You know, this was independent, and then they played together. So I have that here. It's a little wired a little weird, because the middle position is the bridge, and the far, don't ask, I don't know why, and the far right is the bridge. I'm getting accustomed to it, and then this one. Switch number one is that one. And then it's this one and this one. Because there's no way I can get this one to play with this one. And that's fine. I mean, I guess it's fine, but it's a lot. You know, it's a lot. But it's far away enough from the frets that it's not too blort. You know what I mean? Then the other thing was the neck. And the neck was crazy, y'all. It's like, you know, sometimes it's okay and sometimes it's not okay. And recently it's been okay. And I don't know. And I've done everything. I've dressed the frets and everything like that. And I've gone over it and over it and over it. And I don't know. I don't know. I mean, I've played with the truss rod and everything like that. And I've straightened it out. And there's nothing wrong with it. I mean, there's nothing wrong with it. It's just weird. It's like some days it's okay. And some days it's really not okay. And now it's kind of okay. And now it's holding its tune. And so, you know, the usual maintenance on the nut, I'm getting better. And I'm noticing now, even after the maintenance, it's still catching, it's still binding. So it's still, you know, going out of tune and stuff like that. But it's because of the nut. The tuners are Grover tuners. Now, they say Grover tuners, but I've looked at them. And I've looked at what other people have said about the Grover tuners. And if you could see the edge there, I don't know how well you can see that. But they're pretty flat. To the, you know, the shaft is like flat. It's not curved. So at least it's not curved the way they say it's curved, but it looks kind of flat. I don't know what to tell you, but there might be Grover tuners, and Dean might be going, no, what are you talking about? They're real. We got them from Grover themselves, and blah, 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 blah. And I don't know, fellas, you know, I don't know where they made them from, but, you know, I wouldn't be surprised if freaking, if Grover freaking cheaped out and said, you know, well, this is what we got, and we have several different manufacturers that manufacture our brand, so why don't you try these and sell these in bulk, because they're cheaper. You never know. I mean, that could happen. I mean, especially if you're buying in bulk. There is a slight buzz. I'm hearing it more and more as I'm listening to it. There is a slight buzz. And I lowered it because I had to lower the action. The action was a little too crazy high. But I lowered it a little bit. I didn't want to lower it way too much because I do want to do some slide on it eventually. But I'm going to try to figure out what freaking strings are best on here. And all that good stuff, you know. Outside of that, the inside had a block. The inside had a block. It's done with H bracing. So it has a brace here, and then a block in between. And it's all just mainly set up so that the arch doesn't collapse from the pressure of the from the stress of the strings. There's a block over here, and there's a block at the neck. So what I did was, fortunately, the way that it was set up, if I put a piece of poplar about 1.5 inches wide by 1 inch deep from the block here, let's say, from the block here to the block here, it would be able to sit up against the small block that these things are mounted to, the pickups are mounted to, and then the bracing is at the same height so that it also hits that bracing, the H block bracing. So, and then it's just ever so slightly, it's wedged up against this block and this block, like I said, those two blocks. And so you have a full contact resonation board, sound board, going from the tail through the neck. So that increased the resonance of the strings. I'm going to say 100-fold because it rings forever now. I mean, it rings forever. But at the 12th fret, it rings normal. So, I don't know. I don't know what to tell you. It does collect a lot of dust, though. So, I don't know. And outside of that, that was it. I mean, but like I said, when I put the cap on, I clamped it down tight and I clamped it down even. It slid. It moved. It moved about, I'm going to say, a good millimeter. And so it's a little bit uneven. You can't see it from your house, and you wouldn't know it, but I know it. You know what I mean? So at some point in time, I'll have to freaking reset it. And that's going to be a bitch. And but it's going to have to be done. And I just, it's going to bother me enough that it's going to have to be done. Absolutely has no freaking, there's absolutely nothing for the tone. You know, it doesn't change the tone or anything like that. The it's comfortable as hell, man. And it just, I haven't put it down. You know, I mean, I've been helping my daughter back and forth and taking care of housework and stuff like that. Parents finally left. So, you know, getting everything back in action, back together the way it was before they came is, you know, it's always a process. I had the Joyo American on before, and I had it set to some setting that sounded really good. I have it piped directly into the mixer, and the reason why I did that was because when I was using the mic to get the tone off of this, for some reason it was in this position. It was sounding like blart, and it, and not only that, but it wasn't giving the P90s the benefit of the doubt of sounding decent in the neck position, you know, in the neck position and in the middle position for that, because the bass was just too in the room. It's just, and for some reason the way those speakers are kicking it out. So I got a pipe straight in, so this way you can get a little bit better feel of what it sounds like. Unfortunately, I don't know if it's going to be sounding that okay. I don't give a shit. I'm sending it up the way it is right now because, like I've said, this is the sixth. I think this is the sixth video that I've done. Here's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. This is the seventh. Seven? This is the seventh. This is the seventh video that I've done. Not all at this speed, but but I mean at this length, but still. I mean, okay. that note. Peace, people. Have a good one. The Palomino. Let's tell Dean we want... You can name the fat one. The fatter one. The Clydesdale. And we'll name this one the Palomino. Or I can just keep this one. And nobody can have the better one. Oh, it's better, all right. It's better. It's better because I did it. But yeah, that's what I mean. It's a slimline now, so it's slamming. Slamming. Love it. I love it. So, peace. Happy new old guitar day. Have a good one, people.